Now talk about the next topic of the chapter, chemical kinetics, and topic name is molecularity of reaction. Before talking about the molecularity of reaction, we just come to know, recall our last topic, that was law of mass action, RLE, rate law expression, and order of reaction. In case of law of mass action, we saw that rate of reaction depend upon the stoichiometric coefficient, and it was the theoretical aspect, theoretical value. While the RLE, it was the experimental value, and rate do not depend upon the stoichiometric coefficient. And further, when we come to know about the rate law expression, it means RLE, we can find out order of reaction also. Right? Now, we come on our next topic. This is molecularity. What means molecularity? Molecularity means it is the total number of molecules that get collide. It may be atom, ions, and molecules that get collide at the one time to give a product. It means what? Molecularity can't be more than 3. Why not more than 3? Let's suppose 4, 5, 6, and so number of molecules, when they come near to each other and get collide, they are not be able to collide simultaneously. It means at a single of time, more than 3 molecules can't collide and give convert into the product. That's why maximum molecularity for a reaction can be 3. Right? So molecularity is what? It is the total number of reacting species, atom, ions, or molecule that must collide with one another simultaneously so as to proceed chemical reaction known as molecularity. To know about the molecularity, first of all, we must know about the type of reaction. Reactions are of two types. These are simple and complex. Simple reactions are also known as elementary one. So first of all, we will talk about the simple and elementary reaction. Simple reaction, it's clear by the name. It means all those reactions which will complete it in single step known as simple reactions, right? If they will complete in the single step, it means no intermediate will be formed, only transition state will be formed. Got my point? No intermediate will be formed if a reaction takes place in single step. Only transition state will be formed. If reaction takes place in single step, it means total number of molecule get collide single time. At a time, it means molecularity will be what? Molecularity will be the total number of the molecule which take part in simple type of reaction. I think you understand my point. It means molecularity is what? Total number of the reactant molecules. And in case of simple type of reaction, order of reaction is also same as the molecularity of the reaction. These are the key points you must be remembered about the simple or elementary types of reaction. For simple type of reaction, what you have to remember? First one is what? Takes place in single step. Second thing is what? No intermediate will be formed. Only transition state will be formed. Next is what? For a simple reaction, molecularity is sum of the reacting molecules. And next is order of reaction will be equals to the molecularity of the reaction. So all these are the key points regarding simple and the elementary type of reaction. Now, I tell you, molecularity can't be negative, zero, or fractional value. Why not it can't be negative? Or why not it can't be zero? Okay, I write. Molecularity can't be negative, zero, or fractional. I tell you, molecularity is what? Molecularity means number of molecules that collide at a single time, right? What means zero? Zero means what? No reacting molecules that collide. So it is not possible. Zero molecularity is not possible. Fractional means what? Half or 1/4 molecule, it would not be able to collide. That's why molecularity also can't be fractional value. And what means of the negative? It means what? Molecularity is always positive integers value. So molecularity kya hote hai? Positive integers values hoti hai. One more very, very important point. by watching we can't judge any reaction is simple or complex. Now my next point is that only by seeing a chemical reaction we can't say that particular reaction is simple or complex. If you got my point, then give the answer of this particular question. If I'm writing a general expression for a chemical reaction, I want to ask what would be the order of reaction and tell me this type of reaction is simple or complex. Just pause this video and give the answer of these two questions. Yes. Okay, now I tell you the answer and now match your answer. Order. I hope you write order would be 2 and you write it is a simple type of reaction. Most of the students' answers will be the same, right? If it is, answer is wrong. Why wrong? I tell you just before 2 minutes ago that any reaction only by seeing can't be judged that it is simple or the complex. There is no mention anywhere it is a simple or elementary type of reaction. If there is no indication that reaction is simple or elementary, we can't say it is simple one. And if it is not simple one, we can't say it's order 2. Right? If I write simple here, now order is 2 and it is a simple type of reaction. I think you understand what I want to tell you. In case of simple type of reaction like this, if simple is written, only then you can say molecularity is the total number of the reacting molecules. It's mean 2. If molecularity is 2, order will also be 2. That's clear. And for this, rate will be equals to what? Rate will be equals to K into concentrations of the reactant. Like this. I hope you understand this point. Next, molecularity, it may be unimolecular, bimolecular and termolecular. It depends on the number of the reacting molecules that collide simultaneously. If only one molecule, it would be the decomposition reaction like that. If there is only one molecule, it is known as unimolecular. If there are two molecules that collide, it would be the bimolecular. If there are three molecules that get collide to give a product simultaneously, it would be the termolecular. If I write R gives to P, means one molecule of reactant gives out the product, it is example of unimolecular. Right? If I write R1 and R2, there are two types of reactant molecules that get collide to give product. It is example of bimolecular. And if I write 2R equals to P, again it is a bimolecular type of reaction. Now if I write 2R1 plus R2, there are three molecules and again all these are the simple type of reaction. So we will see it is a termolecular type of reaction. It means we can judge if simple is written. It is the case only in case of simple type of reaction. Simple type of reaction, we can say molecularity on the basis of the number of the reactant molecules, right? If you understand this problem, if you understand this case, then write down. Now, you have to solve a problem and now write down RLE and find molecularity and order. You have to find out RLE and find out molecularity and order. For what? 2R1 plus R2 gives out product. And mention is, it is simple type of reaction. Right, you have to find out RLE, molecularity and order for this reaction, and answer you have to message me. Okay, now second type of reaction, it is the complex type of reaction. It is very, very important. Complex, by name it is clear, it means it will take place in more than one step. Right, first thing is that more than one step, that's why it is complex one. If it takes place in more than one step, definitely intermediate will be formed. Clear my second point? And third point is what? Each step, each single step is considered as simple or the elementary step. For example, if I say particular complex reaction takes place in three steps, so all the three steps separately act as the simple or elementary steps. Right, or in case of simple and elementary step, we can find out the molecularity of each step. Overall molecularity has no means. You have to find out only molecularity of the steps, each steps, elementary steps. Overall molecularity, it doesn't mean that. My point, got my point? Next is what? RDS. What is RDS? Rate determining step. Definitely, if a complex reaction takes place in three or four steps, so out of these three and four steps, only one step will be the slowest one. And the slowest step is the rate determining step. It means RDS. How? I tell you by a general, a common example. I take an example of the factory like this. I take example of shirt manufacturing factory. Right, in shirt manufacturing factory, all things are there: fabric, buttons, cuff, collar, all things, all the persons who will stitch the shirt, and overall all the and the person who will tuck the button, etc. Now condition is what? The person who will tuck the button, his speed is the slowest one. Right, now shirt is ready but without button. Is it ready to go to the market for the selling? No. Why not? Because shirt do not has button, and the speed of the person who will tuck the button is the slowest one. That's why shirt is not ready for the marketing. You got my point? What I want to tell you? Why not shirt is ready for the marketing? Because shirt is not completely ready. And why not ready? Because the person who will tuck the button, his speed is slow. It means shirt manufacturing will depend upon the person who will tuck the button. It means whose speed is slowest. That's clear? In case of chemical reactions too, chemical reaction product mein convert ho raha hai, rate will depend on what? Rate will depend upon the slowest step. If there are three or four steps, then rate always will depend upon the slowest step, not on the fastest step. Got the point? I hope you will understand it. Always remember, rate of the complex reaction always determined on the basis of the slowest step. When RLE will be written by the slowest step, it means order will be also find out by the slowest step. It means slowest step is the main step. Okay, and order, it may be zero, it may be negative, it may be friction, it may be positive, all are the possibilities. We will consider one by one in our next videos. Okay, so now what are the key points? Reaction takes place in sequence of number of steps, and each step is elementary step. It is the main thing, her ek single step elementary step hoga. And molecularity of each step can be measured, but overall molecularity for a complex reaction has no meaning. In last topic, we came to know that for the simple reaction, we can find out molecularity only by adding the number of reacting molecules. So in case of complex reactions too, if there are number of simple steps, number of the steps, by each step we can find out the molecularity only by adding the number of the reacting molecules. Okay, and so last step is the rate determining step. Now I tell you by an example also, and ROR, it's mean rate of reaction, can depend upon the will depend upon the rate determining step, and order of reaction will also depend upon the rate determining step, right? And order can be zero, negative, fraction, etc. I hope you got my point. Samajh mein aa gaya hoga. Now sum up. In short, I can say all the reaction which takes place in more than one step known as complex one. Intermediate will be formed in case of complex reaction. Molecularity is not equal to order. Definitely molecularity, overall molecularity we will not judge. We will judge molecularity only for the steps, and order depend upon the slowest step only. And ROR and order will depend upon the RDS, it's mean the slowest step. Now how we will find out the order in case of the complex reaction? In simple reaction, order finding was the too simple. Molecularity equals to the order. But in case of the complex reaction, when molecularity is not equals to order, how can we find out the order of reaction? There are two ways, and we will consider one by one both, right? Example one. When first step is RDS, it means first step is slowest step. We have two cases. First step is what? When first step is RDS. I have given one example. In this example, first step, it is the mechanism. Step first is NO2 plus NO2. It means two molecules of nitrogen dioxide give what? NO and NO3. It is the slowest step. And second step is what? NO3 combined with carbon monoxide CO to gives out carbon dioxide and nitrogen dioxide. Now I tell you, first step is slow, second step is fast. So we will not consider second step. We will consider only first step. If first step is slow, it is the too simple. Now it become the simple reaction, simple type of reaction, right? Now you can write RLE or ROR, rate of reaction. How? K, concentrations of the reactant, like this. Okay, now what is its order? Order is 2. That's it. In case of the complex reaction in which first step is slowest one, it is too simple to find out rate of reaction and order. It simply depend upon the number of the reactant molecule of the slowest step. But where is the problem? Problem in second type of questions, where the RDS involve reaction intermediate. I give you next example. Now again, in this mechanism there are two steps. First step showing equilibrium state, second step showing a simple reaction, and second step is the slowest step. Right, in second step, slowest step, agar main aapse is case mein RLE likhne ke liye kehti hu, to what you will write? RLE, or you can say ROR, equals to K, concentration of NO3 and concentration of NO. Okay, it must be right. Most of the student will write in the same manner. अरे मैम, अभी आप ही ने तो कहा था रेट विल डिपेंड अपॉन द स्लोएस्ट स्टेप, एंड आई राइट द ROR ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ द स्लोएस्ट स्टेप. बट नो, इन दिस केस स्लोएस्ट स्टेप कंसीडर मींस वन ऑफ द रिएक्टेंट ऑफ द स्लोएस्ट स्टेप कंसीडर द इक्विलिब्रियम स्टेट ऑल्सो. इक्विलिब्रियम स्टेप ऑल्सो, इट मीन्स NO3 which is one of the reactant also exists as equilibrium with NO and O2. That's clear. That's got my point. It means rate of reaction will also depend upon these two reactants. Okay, so now ROR is not this one. For this you have to write down equilibrium constant for the one of the reactant which is the part of the slowest step. Now how you will write the equilibrium constant? Equilibrium constant is what? Equilibrium constant are the concentration of the product over concentration of the reactant, राइट पढ़ा हुआ है लास्ट ईयर इन 11th इक्विलिब्रियम चैप्टर वी स्टडीड अबाउट इट. तो कैसे लिखना है ना, आई विल राइट डाउन इक्विलिब्रियम कॉन्स्टेंट फॉर द फर्स्ट रिएक्शन कॉन्सेंट्रेशन ऑफ प्रोडक्ट ओवर प्रोडक्ट ऑफ कॉन्सेंट्रेशन ऑफ रिएक्टेंट लाइक दिस. ओके नाउ आई कैन फाइंड आउट द कंसेंट्रेशन ऑफ द NO3. कंसेंट्रेशन ऑफ NO3 इज वॉट, के इंटू NO कंसेंट्रेशन इंटू O2 कंसेंट्रेशन. आई कैन राइट डाउन दिस वैल्यू इंटू द स्टेप फर्स्ट. हाउ कैन आई राइट इंटू द स्टेप फर्स्ट, ROR इज इक्वल्स टू वॉट, के डैश इंटू के कंसेंट्रेशन ऑफ NO, कंसेंट्रेशन ऑफ O2 एंड कंसेंट्रेशन ऑफ NO अगेन दिस वन. मैंने इस कंसेंट्रेशन ऑफ NO3 की जगह ये सब वैल्यू पुट किया है, राइट. अगेन नाउ कॉन्स्टेंट इंटू कॉन्स्टेंट, अगेन वन मोर टाइप ऑफ कॉन्स्टेंट, के डबल डैश कर लेते हैं. कंसेंट्रेशन ऑफ NO स्क्वायर एंड कंसेंट्रेशन ऑफ O2, इट is ROR. For this mechanism, ROR is this one. And order is 3. 2 and 1, 3. Right? Now, it's a typical one at the first sight, but it is not. If you will practice in one time, it is too simple. What you have to do? First of all, write down rate according to the slowest step. Now look at the particular reactant which involve in the equilibrium step also, right? And now write down equilibrium constant aur uske baad us concentration value ko aap ROR mein put karke final RLE find out kar lo. It is the final RLE. Okay, if you understand all these topics, then there are two practice problems based on these two, order of reaction, finding of the order of reaction in case of complex reaction. What are the problems? Write RLE and find order of reaction for. First is this one, second is this one. For this reaction, mechanism is given, and for this reaction, mechanism is given this one. Okay, so mechanism is first step is slow, and in case of second step is slow. Right, now you have to do these two problems and find out its answer and message me what is your answer. If you have any problem, you can ask to me again. Okay, in next video, we will talk about the zero order reaction. Till then, goodbye.